In this illustration, we'll be discussing about a moving shell bursting in fragments. We are given that a shell flying with a velocity 500 meters per second bursts into three identical fragments, so that kinetic energy of the system increases 1.5 times. And here we are required to find what maximum velocity can one of the fragments can attain. Here in solution, if we draw the situation, we can see a shell of mass m is flying, say, with a speed u. And if it splits in three identical fragments, then one fragment can attain maximum velocity, which is moving in the direction of motion. Say this is moving at a speed v1, which is maximum. And for it to be maximum, other two must move in the direction opposite to motion with the velocity v2 and v2. As if these two are considered to be moving at some angle, this velocity will be less than maximum, because only a component of these two parts along the direction of motion will be responsible for its velocity. But if these two fragments are moving opposite to motion, this will gain a maximum velocity to conserve momentum. So here we can write by conservation of momentum. In this situation, we can write initial momentum was mu, which must be equal to m by 3v1 minus twice of m by 3v2. Here v1 would be the maximum velocity attained by one of the fragments. And we are also given the final kinetic energy of system to be 1.5 times the initial one. So it is 1.5 times half mu square is equals to half m by 3v1 square plus twice of half m by 3v2 square. Now, if we substitute the value of v2 here from this first relation, we can see here m gets cancelled out, and this is giving us the value of v2 is equals to, here you can see this v1 by 3 minus u, and then we can substitute the value of v2. So here the value of v2 is v1 minus 3u divided by 2. If we put it over here, you can see the value we are getting is this will be 1.5, which is 3 by 2u square is equals to this 1 by 3v1 square plus this will be 2 by 3 times V2 value is V1 minus 3U by 2 whole square. On further simplifying, this expression will be getting 9U square is equals to 2V1 square plus V1 square plus 9U square minus 6UV1. Here this 9U square can be cancelled out. And on simplifying this, giving us 3v1 square is equals to 6uv1. Here 1v1 can again be cancelled out. And the value of v1 we are getting is 2u. As the value of initial speed is 500 meters per second, this 2 into 500 comes out to be 1000 meters per second. That will be the result of this problem. The maximum speed which one of the particle can attain after bursting of the shell.